Alright, so what's going on, guys? My name's Chopper, and welcome back, everybody, to a brand new video on the channel. Today, we're going to be a little bit more critical and look at some of the problems that are facing PUBG right now, so hopefully that we can go and find solutions. Now, this is going to be a list of what I think are the biggest issues holding this game back right now, and if we were able to overcome all of these hills, this game would absolutely shine. So before we get into all that, if you guys end up enjoying the video, if you could spare a second to leave a like rating, it does help me out a lot, and hopefully this will help it be able to see it by other people, and we can get a solution to these problems. And also, make sure that you are subscribed if you are brand new to the channel, so you don't miss any more videos just like this or live streams that I do also. And also, I want you to let me know in the comment section what your biggest problem with PUBG is right now. But don't just go and blindly start hating and, you know, type furiously on your keyboard about stuff you don't like. Try to at least be somewhat constructive with it, maybe provide a solution or something. If you don't have a solution, lay out your argument or your problem in the most civil and understandable way possible. With all that out there, ladies and gentlemen, let's go and get started on this list of the biggest problems that are facing PUBG right now. So coming in first on our list today is one of PUBG's biggest problems, but it's the easiest one to point at. It's not super easy to find a solution, but this is the one that I typically hear from PUBG players all the time about what, you know, problems that the game has. And this is going to be its issues with poor optimization and performance. Now, I completely understand the argument when it comes to people complaining about performance, because before I was able to get the computer that I have right now, I did have a little bit of issues, you know, running the game and stuff like that. And I totally understand, but I feel like this is more of a problem on console than anything. The Xbox version of PUBG has made leaps and bounds in improvement, but still really isn't great in my opinion. And the PC version does struggle here and there with performance, really depending on the setup that you have, and mobile actually runs pretty well. Now, unfortunately for PUBG, for all of these performance issues and optimization about it to be completely fixed for everybody, PUBG would pretty much need to be rebuilt from the ground up. The way that it was originally designed was not meant to be the game that it is today. PUBG got way too big for its boots, so to speak. The way to visualize PUBG right now is think of kind of like a cardboard box that is supposed to be able to hold 5 apples, right? That's the weight that it can hold. Put those 5 apples in there, and then now on top of that, throw in like a watermelon, a cantaloupe, and some other heavier items onto this. It's really not supposed to be able to hold that, and you can see where the game will start to break, or the box will start to break in this scenario when you do add that stuff. And that's kind of what we're seeing with the issues right now as far as connection and optimization and performance in PUBG. But I'm not going to sit around and beat a dead horse. We all know that the game isn't perfectly optimized. That's no secret, but it has made so much progress in the past year as far as like getting better with that, but it still has a long ways to go. And I feel like the only way to fully perfect it would be to rebuild the game from the ground up. Now, coming in next on our list today is a point that has a good and bad to it. It has a pro and con, but this is going to be how slowly the game changes. Now, you can compare this to, obviously, the easiest target of the Battle Royale game that changes very quickly, of course, Fortnite. Now, I also think that that is a bad thing as well. If a game changes too quickly, adds too many things before the players really get a hold and a grasp of that stuff. The downside to changing very slowly in the case like PUBG is the fact that players tend to get burnt out and a little bit tired of the content that they play over and over again, and it just adds up to fatigue. And we all know that we're very familiar with games that become stale, and that's kind of the curse that PUBG has been facing. But on the other side of that coin, a game like Fortnite that changes very, very quickly and adds things all the time, changing the game up in you know, different ways possible, that's not necessarily a good thing either. Now, I'm not saying that Fortnite is a dead game by any means. PUBG is not a dead game. You know, I don't like throwing that term around too much because it doesn't even really mean anything anymore these days. But Fortnite definitely has been losing numbers since pretty much the beginning of the year, where it peaked in January, and it's been falling ever since. Now, its active player count has been falling, and I think that the reason why, or at least a big part of it from what I've been able to gather and talk to, you know, very active Fortnite players, is the fact that sometimes the game changes very quickly, and if you take more than like 3 days up to a week off, the game is completely different, and it really sheds off its players that maybe aren't as dedicated. And of course, not to mention, when a game is changing that fast, it's no longer the game that you fell in love with, to a point when it evolves into something completely different. So it's always been kind of my theory that the reason for Fortnite's very big spike and then downfall was the fact that it artificially sped up its own natural game's life cycle by adding in too many things at one time and shedding off all of those players that probably weren't as familiar with it. You're stuck between two bad options. You can change very quickly and have that happen to you, or you can do what PUBG does right now and add content very, very slowly. The content that comes in is always quality and people enjoy it, but it just comes in, you know, not very often at all. So I think, in my opinion, you really need to find that middle ground, but it's not really a win-win situation no matter which way you look at it. Now, coming in next on our list today is a little bit of a tie back to our first point about the optimization and things like that, but the whole Fix PUBG campaign is a good idea, and I'm behind the premise of it, but my issue with it right now is that most players, or just the general populace, aren't even really aware exactly what's going on with it. If you want to do your research and you want to do your digging, you can find out exactly the changes that PUBG's making, but I feel like it wouldn't hurt if they were a little bit more open and maybe in your face about exactly what they're fixing, like, hey, you get on the game, and the message of the day is we're working on tick rate for the next week. Like, go out of your way and show people the tangible benefits that have been added to the game as you're fixing this, quote unquote, apparently. And I don't think that would be a bad idea at all. And I think people would appreciate something that maybe is a big issue to them and it got fixed in maybe the latest patch, or it's being fixed in the next update that's coming out. I believe just a little more communication and transparency from them wouldn't not be a bad idea at all. Now, taking our next spot on this list is the late addition of the training grounds mode. Now, I believe that this should have been a feature in the game that maybe should have been at launch or near after launch. This was way too late for what it was. Now, I know this was added already into mobile earlier than the PC version, but honestly, the mobile version is under different management, so it kind of really just does its own thing. It still follows the general agenda of PUBG for like the PC and console versions, but it also just kind of goes on and does whatever it wants to be honest. Now, the premise of the training grounds is a great idea, and I'm very happy that we have it in the game already, but you know, it's been a long time coming. I know and I understand the roadblocks that they face trying to get it standard and optimized to have it ready for the full release of the game, and it did take a while, but essentially what it is giving you all the tools of everything in the game. So weapons, attachments, vehicles, anything you want to do, you can do in the training grounds. And I feel like honestly that should be something that is available to the player no matter what, right? We still have the main battle royale version of the game, but you should be able to kind of take apart and use these different assets that are already in it, and maybe a lobby by yourself and practice with stuff. They wanted the training grounds mode to be a social experience as well, but I don't think having it in a public lobby and the way it's set up like a regular match was really necessary, to be honest. I feel like having its own separate lobbies to where you can invite players or maybe even load it to you by yourself would not be such a bad idea. The training grounds was great, but honestly, what we need to ask ourselves is, was it too little too late? The training grounds in mobile came first, but it's pretty much just a gun range. It doesn't have all of the features that the PC version has, but it came out so much earlier. And as I did say that they were under slightly different management, so it makes sense, but it's something that like you would assume that the PC version would be already kind of working on as well. Now, coming in next on our list, two more spots we have to talk about. This one is going to be why custom games fail. Now, I'm not saying that the custom games in PUBG are entirely pointless, because they're not. Like, I've used them a few times, and the number one big thing, the benefit that comes out of them, is that they're very easy to help set up, like, for Twitch tournaments and stuff, or, you know, content creators playing against each other on tournaments that we, you know, need to set up very quickly. And while I think that was the idea behind them adding custom games also into PUBG, I feel like for the average player that just maybe wants to play with a few friends and have a smaller game, this isn't really accessible to them. It was before custom games were added into the main game that it was only for PUBG partners, and you had to be invited through a partner if you wanted to play in custom games. So first of all, it made it very exclusive, and most players right now, if they haven't been on the game in a while, assume that they still can't play custom games whatsoever. And another huge problem holding it back is that you cannot load into a custom game on solo. I believe right now the minimum amount of players you need is 8 to be able to load in, but as a content creator, at least a few months ago, this would have been so helpful for me if I could jump into a game by myself and maybe find some equipment that I need or a specific gun setup or whatever. But you cannot load into a custom game solo, and for just the average player to be able to find 8 people minimum to load into a custom game for whatever reason really isn't ideal. The zombie mode is a cool idea, but again, doesn't get much playtime because of these same problems that it faces. And I think that custom games could have been a lot, but it was a little bit underwhelming and flopped in my opinion. Now, finally, coming in last on our list is my biggest issue personally. This is going to be the lack of rewards in PUBG. Now, they tried to do this thing a while ago called the Sanhok Pass, very similar to the Battle Pass in Fortnite, to where you unlock more rewards as you play. And you had to pay, I believe, $10 to get the Sanhok Pass, and you can get these items that come with it. And this was a good idea on paper, but I don't think it played out how they thought it would. Now, I'm not going to talk about all the problems of the Sanhok Pass, because that could be a separate video on its own. What I am going to talk about is the solutions that we could have for rewards. Honestly, just putting a number and a max rank for time played on somebody's player icon would make them grind a lot more. People just want to have that highest rank just to say they do. But even better, if you want to have a kind of skill rank, PUBG Mobile has a very cool system to where they have badges that are skill tiers. And I don't know what the highest one of that is, but so many people would grind just to have that highest tier badge as a bragging right. I also suggested that you should tie skins or weapon camos also to maybe these ranks, or a certain amount of time played will unlock you a special Scar-L skin or whatever, you know what I mean? Instead of putting all of these new cosmetics into crates that people have to buy, attach just a few of them to a specific rank, or you need to have this many hours or this many headshots with a certain weapon, this many kills while in the blue, or just, you know, dumb challenges like that. Give players something to do in the game besides mindlessly grind. And when all is said and done, that is my biggest issue with PUBG, is the lack of rewards for players playing the game. That's what games are about at the end of the day, being playing something, having fun, and being rewarded for that as well. And I don't really know a solution that would be a one-all be-all, but that's what I suggest. If you guys have anything better that you'd like to suggest for rewards, then feel free to let me know in the comment section. I'd love to get a discussion going about that. But anyways, guys, thank you all so much for watching the video. That's going to be it for today. I appreciate you all watching. If you enjoyed it, be sure to leave a like rating, subscribe if you are new to the channel as well, and I'll see you all on the next live stream or the next video. Take it easy, guys, and peace out.